But because potassium channels have become more active, so potassium losses become very, very heavy. There's a heavy potassium efflux. And as more and more potassium is going out, it means more and more positive charges are going out. It means cell will again start developing electronegativity because cell is losing the positive potassium. So when potassium keep on moving out, what really happens? That cells, due to loss of positively charged potassium, become progressively electronegative. And potassium is progressively being lost. Potassium is being lost until membrane potential again becomes at which value? Resting membrane potential value, that is minus 90 millivolt. Is that right? So what happened during this time? What happens really? That electrically, membrane has come back to its negative polarization. If membrane has come back to its negative polarization, it means membrane is repolarized. Due to potassium efflux, membrane has gone to the phenomenon of repolarization. Let's revise it again. What really happens? This was a resting myocardial cell. It was having resting membrane potential of minus 90 millivolt. Is that right? When it was appropriately stimulated, some cations trickled in, entered in. These cations took the resting membrane potential at threshold potential. At threshold potential, voltage-gated sodium channels open. Lot of sodium comes in and then potential goes towards the, it loses all the electronegativity and goes towards the positive side. This phenomenon is called, membrane is undergoing which phenomenon?
Depolarization.
Membrane is depolarized. After depolarization, in ventricular and atrial cells, repolarization process start. In repolarization process, initially potassium goes out, but very soon calcium start coming in. For a brief time, potassium is going out, but at the same time, calcium is coming in. So cations are lost as well as cations are gained. So there is no voltage difference. So we say that electrical potential is showing plateau phase. But eventually, calcium channels shut down and potassium channels become progressively more open. So a lot of potassium leaks out, and due to heavy losses of positive ions, right, membrane become progressively electronegative inside, and potassium keep on going out until the membrane voltage goes back to its resting negatively polarized state. So we say that there is, membrane has gone under the phenomenon of repolarization. So these two processes together, they are called depolarization and repolarization. Is that right? So by stimulation, we say this cell number one has undergone process of depolarization, and after the depolarization, it has undergone repolarization. Is that right? Once this cell went under depolarization, once the cell under, it was undergoing depolarization due to sodium influx, right? The sodium which was coming to the cell, some of this sodium through gap junctions, these are very special connections between the adjacent myocardial cells. Adjacent myocardial cells, neighboring myocardial cells have electrical windows. So what happens? When one cell undergo depolarization, the cations which have come into the cell, some of these cations trickle to the next cell. Here they go to the next cell. When cations from the first stimulated cell trickle into next cell, what really happens? Then resting membrane potential of the next cell will reach up to, yes please, reach up to threshold. And then what will happen? Voltage gated sodium channels will open into this. Then same thing will happen. For short time, voltage gated calcium and potassium channels will be open simultaneously. Eventually calcium channel stop, but potassium channel keep on working, and losses of potassium eventually take the membrane potential back to its resting situation. So it means depolarization of one cell led to the depolarization of second cell. And when second cell is depolarized, when second cell gains lot of cations, it trickles the cations into third cell, and then third cell undergoes the process of depolarization and repolarization. It means that this fluctuating potential of the membrane, right, the membrane fluctuates from resting membrane potential to depolarization, and then it fluctuates back to repolarization. This depolarization and repolarization, they are moving in the cell membranes. Because depolarization and repolarization are moving, so this fluctuation, total electrical fluctuation of depolarization and repolarization, because it is mobile, it is called action potential. Is that right? Let me write it more clearly. That there is, yes, resting membrane potential, and with proper stimulation, there is stimulation. Resting membrane potential will lead to the membrane to, yes please, depolarization. Then depolarization will stimulate initially calcium and potassium channels, but eventually potassium channels become very active and a lot of potassium goes out, and that leads to repolarization. And as depolarization and repolarization are moving on the membrane, so both of them together, they are called action, yes please, action potential. Is that right? So in next discussion, when I say that cells are undergoing depolarization, it means cell is gaining cations, usually sodium. In case of atrial and ventricular cells, they undergo, during depolarization, they gain sodium cations, right? And if there is special point, if there is depolarization of SA node and AV node, remember, depolarization of SA node and AV node is not sodium dependent, that is calcium dependent. So it means when I say that atrial tissue or ventricular tissue is undergoing depolarization, it means those tissues are gaining sodium. And if I say SA node and AV node are depolarizing, it means they are gaining calcium. But anyway, depolarization is whenever cell is appropriately stimulated and a lot of sodium or calcium come in and depolarizes the cell. But whenever cell is depolarized, it is followed by which activity? Repolarization. And this depolarization in one cell stimulates the next cell through the gap junctions. So next cell become depolarized. And second cell will depolarize the third cell. And third cell will depolarize the next cell. So in this way, in the heart, because every cell has electrical windows or gap junctions with the next cell, so electrical stimulation of one cell can lead to the electrical stimulation of the next cell. Am I clear? If this basic concept is clear, now we'll talk about that little bit more in detail, right? Eventually, what we have to understand today, we have to understand that how electrical activity of the heart can eventually be presented as ECG pattern. Is that right? Now, we develop some more basic concepts. Let's suppose here is your heart. These are your atrial chambers, and here we have your, yes please, ventricular chambers, right? Of course, here should be SA node, sinoatrial node, and in between the atria and ventricle, this is fibrous, what is this? Fibrous annulus, right? And the only electrical connection between the atria and ventricle is, what is this? AV node. The only electrical window between the atrial myocardium and ventricular myocardium is AV node. Is that right? So this is SA node, here it is AV node, this is atrial myocardium, and here it is ventricular myocardium, right? Now, ECG.